Hi friends, good morning and welcome. In this video I am going to show you how to build up a 2000 watt dimmer circuit or a variable speed controller. For this you need to have a 2000 watt triac control. Somebody say it is silicon control rectifier, but it is a triac based dimmer circuit or a speed controller. You need to have this one. It is available in Amazon stores by the name 2000 watt dimmer circuit. It is very cheap, available at 200 rupees. And the next thing you need to have is a two-way switch. It is a SPDT switch, available in local stores, rated 250 volts 6 amperes. And you need to have a 3-pin socket, 6 amps 250 volts, and you need to have a gang box play having 4 slots. It is a 4 gang box, and you need to have a 3-pin power cord and some pieces of wire. Now we shall see how to wire the wiring diagram. I will show it to you. So just few words about this one. This has an input and an output, and the first pin is neutral and the second pin is line. This is for input, and the third one is line output, and then it is a neutral output. If you observe it carefully, the neutral, which is at the left and rightmost ends, are directly connected, and the line goes inside and the triac controls the voltage, and the line comes outside. So you have a potentiometer to vary for variation, and this is basically a dimmer circuit which is used for incandescent light applications for dimming, and resistive loads such as heaters, iron boxes, temperature controlling, and for inductive loads it is used for universal motors, drill machines, mixers and grinders. And it is also used to control the fan speed also. The basic advantage is it is very cheap and it has no loss, just like a resistive regulator. Place the module right at the center of the gang box and place the cap over, and it just exactly fits. Here comes the switch, here comes the module, here comes the output socket. This is how the wiring diagram looks like. The earth is directly connected to the 3-pin socket earth, and the neutral comes from the 3-pin cord, power cord, and enters into the controller. And similarly, the line enters into the controller from the input to the input. So similarly, the output from the neutral point is connected to the neutral connection of the 3-pin socket. Here we are using a two-way switch. So this is used for, if you want the output from the controller, you can select the switch, or if you don't, you need not want the controller in its operation, you can directly connect the AC input to the output. So the wiring from the two-way switch looks like this. So from the center pin, you directly connect it to the output. You directly connect it to the output, and from the controller, from the line output, you connect to the another side. Line, and you directly connect from here to here. So if you put the switch in one position, the line from here enters here, and when if you put the switch in this position, directly the line is fed through switch and to the output. And you need the controller or the variation in speed, or you need the dimmer circuit. You can place the switch in this position so that the input enters to this controller and the output from the controller comes to the switch. And when the switch is placed in controller position, and from here it enters into the output. So by using a two-way switch, either you can use the controller or you can feed the directly the 220 volts from here to the output. Means by using a simple switch, either you can use it in the controlling mode or you can use it in the direct mode. So finally the wiring is done according to the wiring diagram which was previously explained here. Now let us test the controller. I have taken an angle grinder, so I'm switching it on. At minimum the voltage is 94 volts. I'm slowly varying it. The voltage gets increased to the maximum. You can also vary the lower limit by varying the small blue colored potentiometer. Can also vary it. So in order to get the lower voltages, I have varied to the minimum of extent. It read as 75 volts, and if I slowly increase, you can adjust the lower limit voltage. I even got up to 46 volts, the lower limit, and I can slowly increase to get the higher limit. And please do not use this for LED dimming. Why? Because all LED lights have drivers in it, so you can't do it, and as well the driver may go faulty. Thanks for watching.